Hello, I'm Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. So here I'm doing the St. Luke 11, verse 27 to 32. A woman in the crowd raised her voice. Remember that the men are closer to Adam of flesh. Semen come from man. Blood come from woman. Blood is life. So women are nearer to our God Elohim, spiritual father. So women are counterpart of God and man is counterpart of Adam. So a woman are more outspoken. They are less hypocrite. A woman in the crowd raised her voice and said to him, "Blessed is the womb that bore you," that she appreciated what Jesus was doing, "and the breast that nursed you." But he said, "Blessed rather are those who hear the word of God and preach it." That means eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ. They are the blessed one. This generation is an evil generation. Remember, Jesus did not fear to call the evil evil. Today, if you call, say I ask these people, Church of England is being headed by Queen. Queen is head of Mammon, and they glorify God by killing people, or by Viceroy of India, Viceroy of South Africa, General, this and that. Their statues are in St. Paul's Cathedral, and they say they glorified God. Whereas the William Booth, who glorified God, he is nowhere to be seen. He is out, and because he did not belong to this fold. His fold is of Mammon. So if you call, tell the people of the Church of England that Church of England is a church of Satan, while Church of Salvation Army people, they are nearer to God. You tell them the Church of England is a church of Satan, see how they pull their faces and look at you. They may call you, you know, all that fury they would spill over you. So, gospel is not easy. It is hard. It is very difficult to preach. People are frightened to speak gospel truth. A Jew is one who is inwardly and not outwardly. Outwardly people, a Levi tribe, Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, they are born and they die. A Jew, spiritual self, never born, never die. So not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. So if you tell people this truth and see how the uproar will come up. These anti-Semitic Jews, they will make a uproar. Remember that these Jews themselves are anti-Semitic, because they are unfaithful to Abraham and to Yahweh, their Jewish God, the creator of male and female. Because a Jew is not physical self, it's a spiritual self. Jew is spiritual self. This is used to be of Judah tribe. Judah tribe people, because they were religiously very well knowledgeable, they started Judaism. They became dominant in teaching Judaism. And from Judaism they became Jew. And that is mean from Judah to Judaism, Judaism to Jew, they become spiritual outward also, and inward also spiritual. How can you have two spiritual? No way. So a spiritual self is inside concerning soul, which is our supernatural self. This is the natural self, tribal self in Adam. this has linked to Adam, our soul has linked to our supernatural father. So a Jew and Judah, they are two different things. Judah is a tribe, Jew is a spiritual self or the way of life. Like Hindu. Hindu and Jew, they are the similar, same thing as Christianity and Sikhism is. Both spiritual selves. So when they become Jew outwardly, then they say bye-bye to their tribal father, Judah tribe. A bastard is born of the prostitute, and that bastard doesn't know who his father is. But these people, born in the tribal homes of their tribal parents, not of fornication, when they become Jew outwardly, they say bye-bye to their tribal self, Judah, and they become unfaithful to Abraham, because Abraham was not a Jew outwardly, he was a Semitic race, and unfaithful to Yahweh, the creator of male and female, all these races, and Adam. Remember, Jesus' name is Yeshua, Yah from Yahweh, and Shua mean Adam. First born of Yahweh, second Adam. Mary was surrogate mother. So he was the son of man. He came among the spiritually sick people of Judah tribe who had become Jew outwardly almost 100%. Only the remnant, which was Jew in spiritually and Judah outwardly, Jesus picked them up. John the Baptist baptized Jewish people, especially of Judah tribe, in majority, in the name of Abraham, to making them the sons of Abraham, or Judah tribe outwardly and Jew inwardly. And he baptized Jesus in the name of his heavenly father, Yahweh. And that's where his name Yeshua come. So such things are not known to the people. And how can they know about the spiritual father if they can't know what is seen with the two naked eye of Yahweh? But he said, blessed rather are those who hear the word of God and preach it. When the crowds were increasing, he began to say, this generation is an evil generation. It asks for a sign. Clever people, you know, they ask sign, but when he give them the sign, they don't want to believe it. As Lazarus, he showed the resurrection in gospel. Lazarus was a friend of Jesus. Friend mean he was preaching gospel like Jesus was preaching gospel. If somebody come to distinguish between Lazarus and Jesus, they could not have distinguished him, because both were preaching gospel. And he being his friend, he too became the son of the Most High, eternal. That is, resurrection was shown in Lazarus to everyone. And those temple priests and others, they became jealous and revengeful. They won't believe in him, believe that he was dead and born, made alive again. Even though the people knew that he was dead for 4 days, they will tell them, no, it's just a magic. So such people, you know, they are not shown the given any miracle or anything, but the simple-minded people who are clean-hearted, they are not hypocrites. To them, the miracles were shown. This generation is an evil generation. It asks for a sign. That means evil means hypocrite. It asks for a sign, but no sign will be given to it except the sign of Jonah, that they know. They read it in the scriptures and they believe that one. Let them believe that as the miracle. For just as Jonah became a sign to the people of Nineveh, so the Son of Man will be to this generation. That means they won't believe in him as they did not believe in Jonah. So That's why in Jerusalem, hardly anybody wanted to talk with Jesus. Remember when those Greeks came and they asked his brethren or his friends, James and John, that we want to speak to Jesus. Then Jesus said, now this, the value of this flesh has been put by these Greek people. And he then was happy to tell them. The queen of the south will rise at the judgment with the people of the this generation and condemn them, because she came from the end of the ends of the earth to listen to the wisdom of Solomon, Queen Sheba, to listen to the wisdom of Solomon, that means which was man wisdom, common sense, Holy Spirit. And Jesus had the very Spirit of God, greater than wisdom than Solomon. See, something greater than Solomon is here. The people of Nineveh will rise up at the judgment with this generation and condemn it, because they repented at the proclamation of Jonah. And see, something greater than Jonah is here. That means Jonah, a prophet. Prophet is a whip for the rabbi, whereas when the rip cannot do anything, rabbis become hypocrite and more authoritarian, and they don't care for the whip or the prophet. As John the Baptist was the last prophet on earth, and they won't let him enter the church, let him enter the temple. The temple priest did not welcome him, so that is why he was in the wilderness. He was proclaiming in the wilderness that Herod cannot marry Philip's wife, which the temple priest could not proclaim because they were Mammon dominated. Herod was the head of that temple, not those temple priests, was not independent. So every year or so, Herod would auction the headship of the temple. The highest the bidder, he will get the headship. Like Church of England, bishops are appointed by Queen, the head of Mammon. Same way, the temple high priest was appointed by Herod, or the king over there. And see, something greater than Jonah is here. Jonah was a prophet, and Christ Jesus is Son of the Most High. John the Baptist was the last prophet. No prophet after him. That means Jesus was not a prophet, but he was the Son of the Most High. So Son is greater than the prophet, because prophets are witness to the light, but not the light. That means they are moon. And Christ is of sun. He is the primary source of light. All the saints are primary source of light, sun, greater than the rabbis and other people. So, hope you enjoy this one.